Oh, hi there. My name's Paul Batch. I wanted to share a little bit with you about my working process in preparation for my show at Tilting at Windmills Gallery. Come on, let's check it out. In my paintings, I try to convey a sense of hope, and I use the landscape around me, particularly the pine trees, as a vehicle in order to relay that. I will often start by sketching outside. Now, this field is just down the road from my home, so it's just a walk away. I've painted here quite often. Pines have always meant a lot to me since I grew up in the woods, and I now look at them as sort of metaphors for life. The town I grew up in was hit by a tornado years ago, and though there was much devastation, you could still see these standing pines throughout the town, the ones that survived. And ever since then, I've sort of looked at them in a completely different way. Now, while outside, what I'll try to do is extract parts of the trees or groupings of the trees that I find interesting. Some arch one way, arching another way. They all can be sort of put together later in the studio to build whatever it is I'm trying to say. Working from life and direct observation is important. Having that connection with nature, with the subject. After I'm done working outside, now in this case it's just a small sketch, but I'll take something like this, and I'll bring it back home, and I'll work it up to something bigger. And I'll start often with a monochromatic underpainting, using just one or two colors. And then from there, I'll intensify the color greatly. I shoot to really push chroma initially, and then I'll calm it down later as I feel the need, depending on what the mood is. I always start with the light. For me, it's all about that light in the back, and that's going to dictate the rest of the colors used in the piece. Here, I've established a light. I'm starting to try to figure out what the snow should go. And here's the final product. Another technique I use often in painting is glazing. So I'll use medium. In this case, it's a neo-magelt, based off of a older traditional sort of medium. I'll mix that with a nice warm yellow in this case and really try to intensify the light. Wiping away some of the excess, and then I'm going to use a complementary color to the yellow purple, and I'm going to glaze that for my darks, and that's going to help push that yellow further, create a visual sort of vibration on the canvas. And then I'll work into that wet glaze, the purple, with the snow. So I'm adding snow. I'm using a turquoise color, but the colors are mixing on the canvas. And I'm trying to just lead your eye through the painting. I got drawn to this melting snow as just part of these transitional moments in our lives and in nature that I just find can be quite meaningful. In addition to glazing, I'll often scrape into my surfaces using a razor, sometimes sandpaper. I build my paintings up with multiple layers, which I think also helps translate like the actual life of the landscape. And then detailed works. I love painting the branches, the light hitting the branches, the delicacy, the way everything moves in and out. Paintings sometimes feel like they can go on forever, you know. That's my work, and I appreciate you being here today. Thanks for coming.